Hey everyone, this is Dr. Steve Orma, and today I want to talk about in this video how I overcame insomnia. So, you know, the way that this became a specialty for me was that I developed insomnia myself back in around 2013. So I am a trained clinical psychologist, went through graduate training and all this stuff. And had been a psychologist for years, I think, 7, 8 years at the time that I developed insomnia. The problem is psychologists don't receive any training in sleep at all. At least I didn't, and my program was pretty representative. This is also true of medical doctors, psychiatrists. Pretty much all health providers receive very, very little to no training in sleep as they go through their training, which is kind of nuts if you think about it, since sleep is a fundamental part of our health. It's what we do. We spend a third of our lives sleeping. Obviously, it's a critical function. I believe it's the number one most important piece of health, more important than anything else for well-being and functioning and health. Receive very little to no training in that. So when I developed insomnia back in 2013, I didn't know what to do. And I tried, all the usual things that people try. The only thing that I was taught in grad school was sleep hygiene. Literally, I was given this like one sheet little, printed handout of like sleep hygiene skills, which I've talked about on this, on these videos many times. They don't work. And that's what I was giving my clients that had sleep trouble. And so when I developed it, then sure, I was trying the same things. And of course, they didn't work. And so, the insomnia went on for like 6 months and it was pretty bad. I would say sort of, not as severe as some, but I was averaging around 4 to 5 hours of sleep a night. Normally I would sleep, 7 to 8 hours a night. This was happening almost every night, probably at least 6 nights of the week I was having that. And that went on for around 6 months before I was like, I got to figure out how to solve this problem. So, what I did was I had to just do my own research to kind of find out what is the best way. Is there a really good way to treat this problem? And I just started reading books and just researching it and trying to find the different approaches that people were using. And I also looked at like the top sleep programs that I could find. So, I was based in the San Francisco Bay Area. So I looked at Stanford, and then Stanford has a sleep clinic and treatment there. I looked at Harvard's. And what I found was that this treatment called CBTI, Cognitive Behavioral Therapy for Insomnia, was, considered the gold standard treatment. And it was the one they were using at all these sort of top sleep centers. And so that's what I decided to go with, because it was evidence-based. It made the most sense. It had been studied a lot. And the thing is that as a therapist, my specialty approach was using cognitive behavioral therapy, which is really the most powerful and effective form of therapy for anxiety, depression, and pretty much everything. And so, I already knew that it was a very effective form of treatment, but this one was specifically created for insomnia itself. So I found, a book that I thought was pretty good on this, that kind of guided you through the process, and I put myself through the treatment. Because I was an experienced psychologist and kind of understood treatments, and I just decided to do it completely on my own. And, this was something that, and basically I did it, and it was extremely challenging because of what's required for the process of overcoming insomnia and going through this treatment and implementing these skills. And it was very challenging, but basically I stuck with it, and within, trying to remember, somewhere between 8 and 10 weeks, around 8 weeks, I pretty much had gotten past the insomnia. And then I would say, maybe a couple weeks later, things were really solid and consistent. And so, you know, I wanted to talk about, you know, I wanted to talk about that today, because when I work with my clients, I'm coming from not just a professional and a clinician and a psychologist. I'm coming from having this experience myself personally. And so I've gone through the trenches, and I've gone through the treatment, the same process that I use. And, you know, I have to say that, like, for me, like, I did it on my own, but, and I'm not saying you can't do it on your own, but I'm saying it's extremely difficult to do it on your own. And I had a great advantage. Number one, I was already a therapist. I already understood cognitive behavioral therapy really well, and how to implement structured treatments, because I had been doing that for years with other disorders. You know, I also had a specialty in anxiety. That was my specialty treatment then that I had been working with. And there's a lot of crossover. A lot of people with insomnia, or most people, have anxiety. And I also am a very disciplined person, meaning that when I commit to doing something, whether it's exercise or a diet or whatever, I fully commit, you know, no matter how hard it is. And that's just something I've developed over time, but that's hard for a lot of people to do and be disciplined in that way. And so I think the combination of those factors really set me up for success with it. You know, combination of that with a really effective process set me up. But most people aren't able to do that on their own, and they struggle, and they get lost, and they don't know what they're doing, because this treatment process is multifaceted and not only can be challenging mentally, physically, and all that, it's there's a lot of skill involved in implementing the skills correctly and the right, and with the right timing. Okay, so then because of those things, I decided to write a book. Now, why did I write a book instead of just, you know, recommend the book that I used? I mean, the book that I used was good, but it lacked certain things that I thought made it a little more difficult for me to implement the process. And I kind of adjusted a little bit as I was going through it, and made it kind of work better for me, and kind of, you know, so it just made the process a little smoother and less stressful. And so I wrote this book that's basically a sleep manual that goes through the steps of CBTI, and kind of added my twists, and I would also give my perspective. So I would sort of go through the treatment and describe exactly how to implement the treatment, but I would also give my perspective on each element from what, when I went through it myself, my experience of it, and kind of things that worked for me that I found along the way. And then, I started working with my clients, because a lot of my clients, as I said, I specialized in anxiety, you know, also worked with other things as well. And a lot of them had sleep problems, and a lot of them were dealing with insomnia. And so I said, hey, like, you want me to work with you on that? And so I started working with clients individually in my practice and helping them overcome insomnia through the same exact process that I went through. And it worked. And I started having success there with my own clients. And so gradually and slowly, this became like a specialty. Actually, not that slowly, like quite fast, because so many of my clients had sleep problems. And so many people had this problem that very quickly I was able to make this a specialty, or add it to the anxiety specialty. And I really enjoyed working with it, because I love the structure of it. I love that it's, you know, very science-based, and it's a very effective treatment. And that's a really rewarding thing to work with, versus other types of treatment or disorders, which are much more nebulous in terms of the treatment. And then, you know, I started getting, I consulted with Calm. So, one of the co-founders and co-CEOs of the Calm app, I was able to meet with him. He also lived, the company was based in the Bay Area. I was able to meet with him, and because he was creating these things called sleep stories at the time, this was back in 2014, and that he wanted to consult with me to, you know, just in terms of like the effectiveness of certain things in helping people sleep. And so I met with him. And then because of that, he asked me to actually create one of his sleep stories. So I was able to record a sleep story, which I believe is still in the Calm app, and it's on sleep science and insomnia. And so basically, slowly, I was able to generate this, you know, to turn this into a specialty and the main thing that I do, and really like a passion of mine and something that I love doing, and where I've built my entire kind of practice and business around is helping people solve this problem for insomnia. So I don't really work with a lot of different issues. I work with a few issues that I go deeply in as a specialist, and that's what I think is the most effective. Just like you have specialties in the medical sciences, I think with a specific problem like insomnia, you want to see someone, you want to get guidance from someone who has a specialty. So basically I started working with my clients, and so I've been doing this now for 7 years and just work with dozens and dozens of clients and developed a whole program for overcoming insomnia. And really what I've done is I've been able to implement and put into this program not only CBTI, which is the gold standard treatment for insomnia, but adding all the nuances and distinctions and extra things that I learned along the way that that really worked for me personally, but also things that I saw missing from CBTI, just sort of gaps that were missing that made it more difficult for clients to get through the process. And I'm continually, even now, trying to make it better and better and better. So, you know, the success rate is even higher and higher and higher than it already is, which is very high just as a base treatment. And so I wanted to kind of like share that with you, because sometimes it helps people to know, like, you know, other people have been through insomnia and they've gotten through it, and that there's a way out, and you don't have to resort to medication and drugs and herbs and sleep hygiene and sleep gadgets and all this crap that you find everywhere on the internet, or that are recommended by you know, therapists or doctors or health professionals. Most of that is just not going to be helpful. It can be expensive. It can make you more frustrated. And all you need is this process. This is all you need is this process to be able to get rid of the insomnia. And it's highly effective. And so, you know, basically to know that this is something that you can overcome and that I've been through it. And I think that is something that my clients have found very helpful for them, that when they're working with me, because when you go through insomnia, right, if you're going through that now, or you've been going through it, you know what a nightmare it is. I mean, you know how horrible it is to be able to not sleep when you want to sleep, and for that to go on for months or years, and how you feel, and then have people in your life that have no idea what you're going through. You know, like a lot of times when I see clients, they have partners who are sort of the opposite, right? They just get into bed and they're out and they sleep. And they don't understand what it's like to have insomnia. You know, they just say, well, just relax, just go to sleep. What's the big deal? And, you know, even if they're supportive, they don't really understand. And you know, that can be very frustrating and make you feel very alone if you're not getting that understanding and support from the people in your life. And so then it's helpful for you to know that, like, hey, other people have overcome this, and that it's possible to overcome it. And so what makes the program really effective and what is that it's science-based and it's structured, and you're going through these steps. There's no guesswork, and it's highly effective because it works with the way the body sleeps. We're just reversing the things that are creating the insomnia and replacing it with the things that create really good sleep. No matter how long you've had insomnia, no matter if you're taking medication or not, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter your age, doesn't matter your gender. This has been studied with, you know, from teens all the way up to, you know, people in their 80s. So it doesn't matter. All it matters is you have the problem. You're sick and tired of having the problem. You've tried everything else, and you want to solve it. And so you know, if this is you and you're at a place where you're just done with it, and this is the number one most important thing in your life to solve, because you need to have that commitment and be in that mind frame to take it on and go through the process. And that's a critical thing, you know, in order to be kind of in the right place for this. And so if that is you and you want to learn more about what this process involves, I've talked about it in other videos, but I put together a free training that you can access on my website. My website is drorma.com. That's drorma.com. And if you go there on the homepage at the very top, there'll be a link that says free training. You click on that and then you can register for it and watch that training. And it kind of goes over the five main steps. There's like, five different aspects to the treatment, and kind of goes over what works, what doesn't work, and what that process looks like. And you can see what that sounds like to you. Does it resonate with you? Does that sound like a good fit? And if it is, then there's an option to book a free call with me, like a consult call, for me to get more details and see, you know, for a good fit to work together. Okay. So again, to do that, you just go to my website, drorma.com, drorma.com. And if you like the video, just click like. If you're on YouTube, and any comments or questions you have, you can put them down there. And any questions you have or any videos you want me to do on this topic, please let me know. I'd be happy to make a video for you about that. Okay, so have a good rest of your day.